Welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox One. On my creative mode save, on the Earth-like planet, for a very, very quick look at Headmaker rotating light work with a lift. Now I've had this lift for a while. It's simply a piston that reverses direction, goes up the exact distance to the floor at the top. When you reverse it, it comes back down. Really simple lift. But I wanted to add a red flashing light that turns on when the lift goes up. And then shuts off. And does the same. And depending on the complexity of your lift, you can do it really easily with just a couple of timer blocks. You could use sensors if you've got a big lift and have it detect the subgrid of the lift so that when it passes through the first sensor, it turns the light on. And when it passes through the second sensor, it turns the light off. But then you'd need it to turn the light on when it leaves the top sensor and vice versa. With this method, you just have two timer blocks. This timer block here, I've called lift and light. So in its actions, let's move down. It tells the lift piston to reverse. It tells the light, which is already off, to turn on, and it starts the second timer block. That's it. That's all you need for the first timer block. And the second timer block has a delay of 5 seconds. And all the second timer block does is controls the light off. Then you have your button panel. And on your button panel, you make sure you start the first timer block, which has a delay of 1 second. So that gives you just a second if you sit on your lift like that. So you replace this particular command, go down to it, press A, and then you find in your list your timer block, lift and light. Choose start. And there you go. One rotating light that works with a lift. And if you want to match this in or hide it, you can hide these timer blocks further into your build. You can put them under the floor, outside, behind another wall. You can hide them with a handy metal floor plate. These plates are really cool. You find them in steel catwalks. Make sure you get the right one. Like that. There you go. one working, rotating light in the lift. That's all there is to it. Hopefully you found this particular very short tutorial useful. There will be more, including, as I said before, it's coming. It's going to take me just a little longer to do the video for it. But as we're here, you can see it's scooting along. There's my cargo container. And heading towards here. Just scooting away after docking. My ice drill. And my automated ice cargo drone system. Now this one does use uranium. Scooting along, look. You could build it with batteries. My suggestion, if you do that, is leave it docked to one of your stations for a few minutes, 5 minutes maybe, just to put charge in the battery. But that is coming, including the actual build of the drone itself, which is really simple. It's just a flying cargo box, and there it goes. And there's not too much to making it dock. I've seen people use the autopilot on off and things like that. You actually don't need to do that on an Earth-like planet. Not sure about in space, but you will actually not have to worry about that. I haven't used the autopilot off function. It will just literally sit there for a minute, drop its cargo off, and scoot off into the distance. If you want to watch it with me, it will not need any other commands. So what I will do is I will also, here we go, I'll put the actual timer blocks and the commands in the description of the video when I do that, so you'll be able to follow along a lot easier. But until then, have a good one. Take care. Stay safe. Happy engineering. Enjoy the game. Bye for now.